Okay. Welcome from the future of Joomla from the year 2020. I want to show you what can happen, what should happen in the next Joomla versions. And coming back to now to tell you about. Of course, in year 2020 we are doing Joomla. And as usual, we have the projects, we're setting up Joomla installation. We are creating content, we are creating all the contacts and stuff we need. And of course, when we're creating content, we have some requirements from the boss and asking, for example, okay, I have a team which creates articles and I want to publish. And the question is this possible with Joomla? Has someone authors in Joomla?
It's not possible. Yeah.
Not. Okay, then we are done. Sorry. Then we are done. Then. Of course. So we have working with content, we have authors, and we have someone who's publishing. And of course, with the access management, you can set up, okay, you are allowed to create, you are not allowed to edit, you are not allowed to publish. And then we have someone who is allowed to publish and who is allowed to edit. The next question is, okay, what's up with notifications? When someone is creating an article, I'm not always in the backend, so I want some notifications via email. Has someone found this function in Joomla already? Getting an email? Yeah, don't be shy.
Yes.
Yeah. So we have this content Joomla plugin, which sends email when a new content is created. Okay, so far so good. We can use in Joomla. Next step is, of course, is this enough? Are you satisfied with this workflow? Someone is creating, someone is publishing, that's it. And the next requirement is, okay, now we have people who proofread, we have people who add images, for example, we have people who publish the article before and someone has to confirm it before. So we have something like that. So we have authors, we have a confirmation, that the article is okay, we have a proofreader, we confirm again, and then we publish. And the question is this possible with Joomla at the moment? I guess not, and if you have something like that, it gets harder and harder and harder. And what we do, or what we want is, we have the three status, unpublished, published, archived, and trashed, and probably that's okay for default handling, but perhaps you want something like that, or you want to add more status, and we want whatever we want to define. And luckily we did something like that in the last at Google Summer of Code. Just summer, Google Summer of Code is a yearly project where Google spends money for students which programs for open source associations like Joomla. So Joomla submit some project and Google pays money for students so they implement this project. And last year we did the publishing workflow with Google Summer of Code. I was one of the mentors from students, so I supported students to implement it. And do you want to see something about the publishing workflow?
Yes.
Sure.
Okay. So we implemented in Joomla 4. Has someone never seen Joomla 4 before? Okay, so what's new in the layout way in Joomla 4 is we have now Bootstrap 4 instead of Bootstrap 2. And we have a new backend template, which will be changed hopefully the next days, weeks. If you are a programmer and like to work on templates, ask Elisa. She's creating a very, very good new template, but she needs some support, so ask her. Okay, what we did is we have our main menu on the left side and we have the content area, and now we have a new menu item, workflows. And our goal of the workflow implementation was to have an unlimited workflow, so we don't have to use this existing publish, unpublish, trash stuff, but if I want to use it, and if I convert, for example, from Joomla 3 to Joomla 4, we want to allow you to say, okay, I don't care about the workflow, I want to use the old stuff, so we implement the default workflow as it is in Joomla 3 for Joomla 4. So if you don't want to use the workflow, you can deactivate it in the options and say, okay, I don't care about anything, the default is okay. And then I can say no, and then you will never have to touch the workflow. Of course, no, we want to use it, and I want to show you how it works. To understand that the new workflows, you have to understand four terms. The first term is the workflow itself. That's just a container. So the workflow holds states, transitions, and conditions. And so we have the next three terms. Next term are the states. States are the states which the article, for example, has. So when I create a state new, a state trash, the article is trash, the article is new. So you define all the possible states which an article can have in the workflow. So let's do this. We create a new workflow. As you can see here, we have a default slider where you can say yes and no. The idea is, if you migrate from Joomla 3 to Joomla 4, you have existing articles which has no workflow yet. So we have to think about a way, what should we do with them? And the idea was, okay, we're implementing the Joomla default workflow and mark it as default. So automatically all articles get this workflow and can work as before. But if you want to change it, we can say, okay, now we have this chat workflow, and from now on, all new articles should be this workflow. I show you afterwards how you can specify different workflows, but that's just for information, okay? We have another chat workflow, which is a default one. So if you create a new article now, it will be default in this workflow. Of course, this workflow is empty or nearly empty, as you can see here. Here you see, okay, we have states and transitions. As I said before, the states are the states where the item, the article is in, and the transitions are the steps between one state to another. So if it's new and someone proofreads it, and then we want to switch it to is proofreaded, we need a transition from new to proofreaded. So let's go first to the states. Default is published. You get always in published, so you can work with it. So let's create a new one. And here again, we have a default state or the default slider. And the idea here is, when you create an article, the article needs an initial state. And the question is, which state should he start from? And here you can define, okay, if I said no, yes, all articles created in this workflow will be new. And then I can start from here and execute transitions. On the other hand, we have the fourth term, conditions. Conditions tells you, is the item with this state visible or not? So when we create a new article and it's new, it should not be visible on the website. So we say, okay, as long as it's new, it's unpublished. And if we close, we have this new, and we see, okay, if an article is new, it's unpublished. And if you would change it to published, then it's published. We can rename this, for example, to see the difference. So we have these two states. Someone's creating an article, it's the default state, then it's new. And then we can change it afterwards to online, and then it's visible on the website. And now we can add unlimited states. It's proofread. If it's proofread, it's still not published, so we want to unpublish it. It's not default because it's in status within the workflow, but not in the beginning. So now we have these three states. And the next question is, okay, how can I define these steps from one stage to another? And that's, as I said, the transitions. And here I can now define what can happen. So I say, okay, new transition. I want, if an article is new, I can change him to it to is proofread. So I said, okay, save new. And if it's proofread, the next step is set to online. And then it's a transition from is proofread to online. So now I have the states, and you can imagine something like that. You have a canvas with the states in a chaotic order, and the transitions draws the errors from one state to another state. So I'm new, and then I can execute all the errors from the, to the other states. So, and the question is now, we have this workflow created, JEP workflow, we have three states and two transitions, and how can I assign them to articles? And we decided to extend the categories. So now you can, on category based, assign workflows. So if you have different categories, you can use different workflow in your system. So here we have this new tab workflow, and here we can assign the workflow to the category. And as you can see, we have used default, means this was this default workflow from the beginning. That's the fallback, that's the default. Okay, if we don't change here something, we will always use the default. But we can say, okay, we want a JEP workflow for this category. So we say, okay, save close. And now we have the JEP workflow for this category.
Just a question, you marked the JEP workflow as the default
workflow.
It's
the same.
So it would be no difference in this
case. In this case, it would be no different. But if it would not be default, then we have to mark it or select
it. You can do it globally.
Yes. And now what we do is we are creating an article. And the first thing you will see, we have no publishing state here anymore when creating an article, because the status will be defined with the category. We assigned the workflow to the category, so we will have this category here. Okay, let's say JEP article. All the other stuff is same as before. You have all the options. The only thing which change is here. So when we save it now, we see our status is new. No, because the new is the default status of this workflow, and the category is assigned to this workflow. So the system recognizes, okay, we have a new article uncategorized, we're looking for the workflow, it's a JEP workflow, and we're looking for a default state, and it's new. And now we can execute this transition. So we can say, okay, now I proofread it. So I change something, and I set it to I proofread it. And as you can see, afterwards you see, is this article then visible or not? And if we proofread it, it's still not visible because it's unpublished. So let's save it. As you can see, now the status changed to is proofread. And now we can set it to online as the next step of our workflow. And I don't do it here because I want to show you something else. If you have a lot of articles, it's not usable to go into the article, change the status, go back and then go to the next article, go back, go to the next article. So you can set the states here. You click on this icon. Here you see if it's published or unpublished on the website. And say, okay, it's proofread. And now we can set it to online. And now it's online and it's on the website. And if I feature it, then it should be here, our JEP article. And yeah.
How does that work with multilingual translation? Is often part of the workflow. Is this on the article level? Does that make everything published, or in specific, or is this individualized by the language that you're working in?
It's You're speaking about a core language, not something like JoomFish or
yeah,
but
core
language. Yeah. The core language, we have for each language one article, so the workflow is for each article individual. At the moment, you have, it depends what you do. If you have an English one and a German one, for example, and they are in the same category, then they share the workflow, but every article has to go through the workflow by itself. If you have different categories, like a German category and the English category, the article is one and the other, you can have different workflows for the article. In the future, we want to implement, that's then next steps, we want to implement some association, some kind of, so you're creating the English one, the article, publish it, and as last step, you can add actions which creates German one with a new workflow. In fact, it's possible already because we have a plugin trigger system in the background, so you could do it by yourself, but it's not in the core, it's not delivered, but you have to create a plugin for yourself, then you can create new article depending on state of other articles.
Can you change the workflow to have like an approval step in it? So you approve the proofread,
yeah,
and from there you'd have a choice of either being able to go back.
Yeah, if you want. Yeah, so we could do something like.
I haven't seen multi-step yet.
We could do something like, okay, if it's proofread, proofread. And we don't want it, we can set it back to new and say, okay, reset.
Okay.
And then let me create a new article. Okay. Article 2. Then we can set it to. I proofread it, and then here we have now both, so we can reset
right.
It to a
right.
New, or so you can unlimited.
Okay.
And if you go to the default workflow in Joomla, here is the case. For example, transitions. Here, from all states, you can set it to publish because we have the four states, and you can change from everything to everything. That's very new. Until a few days ago, you have to set up all transitions. So you have to set up, okay, trash to publish, unpublished to publish, archive to published. And now we have a new feature. So you can say, okay, it doesn't matter where it comes from. You can, all status can change to publish, for example, or mostly you use it for trashed. So, and when I'm here, one important feature is now, okay, we have this transition. Who can execute this transition? Because when someone is creating an article, he should not publish it. And for this, we have a permission here. So you can define for each transition, for each error, who can execute it based on all the default Joomla user group. It's the default handling. So you can create a group authors who has no right to push it to publish, and then you create a group, admins who are allowed to publish, and so you can add access or the permissions to every step.
I have a question, but what happens when someone puts a new article, so this proofreader gets an email, you have to do something, or how does it work?
A good question. Before I showed you this plugin, Content Joomla plugin, which sends the, okay, there's a new article, if you remember from the slide. And we extend this plugin. Let me search it. So we have this Content Joomla plugin. So here you can activate and deactivate email on your article, and we added email on transition execution. So if someone executes this transition, all people who can now execute the next transition gets an email. So not everyone, but only the one who has no permissions to work on it. If you activate it here, and if you activate, user gets email in his profile. There's this user gets system emails check.
But you can't customize those messages then.
Yes. So you get an internal message.
Can yeah, but you cannot configure a specific message for a specific transition.
No, but only the people who are now allowed to execute the next transition gets the email. So not everyone gets the email.
Yeah, but I can imagine that you would like to share a different message for someone that needs a bit.
Not at the moment.
And a different type of message to someone that needs a publisher.
Yeah, but as it is a plugin, you can deactivate it here and write your own plugin. And
yeah, sure, but if you do have to transition, I can also imagine that it will be possible to set the specific message within that transition configuration.
Perhaps.
Are you able to set a note against the article? Because that would actually serve the same purpose.
Yeah.
No.
Can you add a note to the article? So you've done the proofreading, now you want to explain why you're firing it back.
There was a feature request, and I think someone added the note feature. I'm not sure if it's already merged, but...
Let's check.
Because that would achieve what you're looking for, effectively.
Yeah, possibly.
You get the mail, and then you look at the note.
Yeah.
Just
the
version note?
Yeah, the version note, but...
But someone asked on GitHub.
Okay.
That would be really something else to have
that. That would be important as well if you have, I mean, we've often had a situation, for example, you have multiple proofreaders on a content, so, okay, it's fine that you generate an email that goes to all of those proofreaders because they're all with the permissions set to receive that email, but how do they know which one's supposed to react to that? Is there any method at the moment of saying for a particular article, it's going to be this person? I mean, notes field would also, if that notes field gets put into the email, then three people, two of them can just ignore it because they see...
Yeah, but you could solve it by creating different groups. So if you have proofreader, for example, for different topics, you create different groups and then allow... And then you have different transitions. Say, okay, now I want to proofread for the Joomla guy. I want proofread for this guy, and then he gets the email.
Mm-hmm.
The problem with that is that you often will have projects that we've worked on, you'll have proofreaders that come in and go out of their group. Someone will work on it for a month, or then maybe someone, there's a lot of fluctuation. But with the notes field, that would ultimately solve the problem, just that they will get more emails maybe than they would otherwise need. Yeah.
Yeah.
By the way, I'm working on the Google Summer Code project for multi-language associations, and we planned if you save an article that all the other languages get the article automatically created, and at this point we can include the workflow also and say and all the articles are created with the state have to be translated or something.
Yeah.
Not really a question about workflow, but to do with content, will there also be the ability to cut an article into multiple categories?
I think not in Joomla 4. Therefore, they're creating this tag system, so you can tag them different and have different category layouts in a tag view. But I guess it's very hard to change it in Joomla. Not yet, because we created only for COM content, but it's implemented a way that you can use for all extensions. And the goal is, if this is in the Joomla core, the basic, then we can add it to all extensions, which so to the module manager too. Good question. I don't know. I think everyone gets the email because that's the default handler at the moment from Joomla. So
you would have to set the guy doing the final approving would supposedly then be not allowed to set the proofread in order to not get that email.
Yes.
Is there any way to set it up that the proofreader doesn't have to log into the admin area?
No, it depends. To get the email, he has to have access to the administration, but only for the email. But if I log in here, let's see if it's still published. And I edit here in the front end. We can set the state. Okay, we have no access. We have no additional transition, but I show you next feature. You can now. It could be that the workflow is stuck because we have a proofreader who left the company or something like that, and it's stuck. And now, as super administrator, we can reset the state here, but only as super administrator, as super user, we can reset the state in the batch process. And so, if we proof, okay, let's create a new transition back from online. Now, if you are in the front end and have the permission to execute a transition, you can choose it here and change it here too.
Could you open the back end to tell again? I was a bit confused now that I think it was in the when you went to workflows, you were editing the workflow transition. I think it was that particular admin tab. Because on the one hand, there's states,
yeah,
and then there's also, I think in one list it was called the condition, and then at another place the same thing was called status, which was published, unpublished.
Yes and no. That's the reason, because I think you mean this one. We are in the states and have this unpublished.
That was the question.
Yeah.
Can you edit this list? Yes.
Yeah. The left-sided title are only names.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, in Joomla 3, unpublished is unpublished. So we could do something like, say, deactivated. Perhaps then it's more clear. So then we have the deactivate status.
Yeah.
And the item with this status would be unpublished.
So in the list, could you go one step back when you were editing that? No, where you, if you click on the title,
admin.
There, exactly.
That's the status for that.
Yeah, no, I get it. That's my question. On the right-hand side, you've got the drop-down status. What's in that list? So there's three options, and that's
yeah,
which they're fundamental, they're core. You can't change those.
This is the default status,
yeah,
for the status. So you can...
So you can deactivate the
status. Yeah.
You know, I get it, but that particular drop-down, the three options,
yeah,
that's not editable. They are fundamental.
Yeah.
Okay.
We could implement the workflow for the workflow itself and then create a workflow for us, but...
Let's not do that.
Yeah.
Okay, thank
I
you.
I have a question also. Talking about front-end entity.
Yeah.
In order to set that up properly, you probably need to assign different access,
yes,
groups for different articles during the workflow. Is that something that is implemented or could be implemented? Non-proofread article is published, but only for a certain access level?
Not yet.
Shows up.
So, speaking about, I came later to it, I have a slide for, can I answer this question later? I have
yeah,
a slide
yeah,
for it.
Sure.
Then I can speak about the future. The next future. Okay. Yes, any more questions?
This is only for Joomla 4 when creating new articles.
Yes, at the moment.
So, yes. What would happen if we upgrade, for instance, like an old Joomla, V8 something, to this version? What would happen with the workflow and the status of the existing articles there?
At the moment, Joomla contents have field states in the table. So there's between -2 up to 2, which is archived, 1 is published, 0 is unpublished, and -2 is trashed. Perhaps the question is, if you have a third-party module which used this state, what happened with it, for example? We are fully backwards compatible. That means the workflow don't need this state anymore, but we will update the state field. So it's both thing will work for Joomla 4. So the old version will work and the new version will work together. So nothing will break, we just update it. And if you create new things, the new workflow will automatically be used. And as you can see, we have all the states in the field, so you see no difference. You just update and can use it, continue using it. But the system will use the new workflow from now on. but you see no different. And you, all the old modules which make select for the old state field will still work.
As you said, in the existing state field in the database, archived is 2, right?
Yeah.
And your conditions list here only has actually 3 options. It
yes.
doesn't have archived anymore. How's that going to be solved?
The question is, these conditions are, is the item, in this case the article, visible or not? An archive is
article that only displays archive
yeah, then it's visible, so it's published.
Okay, but it would be published in other places as well.
Yeah,
you need to change your layout to be based upon your these field title and this particular list
yes.
rather than condition.
For example, you mean the archive list of articles?
Yeah.
They are implementing at the moment parameter, so you will get the archive list. You select, okay, I want to display all published article which has a state archived.
Okay, yeah.
So it can be more. So at the moment you can only display archived articles in this list,
mm-hmm.
and from now on you can display all type of published article, but you have to choose the parameter in the menu.
It's really nice with the workflows.
Yeah.
So also when somebody wrote the article, then it's going to proofread, and then you get the CO guy just checking metadata
yeah.
and just
for example.
Putting that in. Yeah.
Any more questions?
Yeah. If I'm building a component, I can hook in to comp categories.
Yeah.
Is there any plans to let me hook into the workflows as well?
We did not implement it in contact, but you have this extension. And if you say, OK, I want contact, then you create workflows for contact.
Okay.
And if you have your own extension, of course, you have to implement the interface, which makes a saving for the new workflow in your saving function, for example. And you have to implement the new workflow transition field in your form and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But creating workflow is just changing the extension parameter, add it in the submenu, and you're done.
So that means you can define workflows for contacts and articles for anything else, for users as well?
At the moment, only for content. But the workflow is built so we can integrate it everywhere. Any more questions?
You can exclude archived articles from the search. Would be still possible?
Yes.
Could it be implemented for users?
Yes.
So that when somebody registers, some person is responsible for contacting them and do something else. And
yeah. So for the registration process, for example. Yeah.
Is that something that needs to be, if I want to set that up, do I need to do some development or to add that?
At the moment, you have to implement it into a computer. It's not implemented
yeah,
yet,
yeah.
but yes. The interesting part is perhaps if we start implementing another core extension, you can do with the plugin functionality, it's very powerful. So perhaps you can say, okay, I allow users to submit articles. And now I have this workflow from new proofread published, but from proofread I have also a step spam which trashes it. And then you can create a plugin for yourself which say, okay, when an article is changed to spam, I should look up who is the author, and then I will change the author user group to spammer. You can do something like that if it's implemented in the whole system.
I have a question.
Yep.
Can you implement different views based on workflows for users? For example, if there's a user that's only meant to do proofreading.
Mm-hmm. Not at the moment. The reason is for the plan is to move all the permissions to the workflow. So you can set up, okay, if it's state X, user ABC can do something, and other users can't. This is a plan, but for making this happen, we have to rewrite the whole permission system, and we want to bring this in Joomla 4, not in Joomla 10. Yeah, but it will be possible somewhere in the future.
Yeah, because it could be great to have some kind of default
yeah.
views for
it makes definitely sense.
You could do that in a temporary override.
Yeah.
Yeah, for example.
Yeah, yes.
Okay. So just sum up about the current status. So what we did. We create a core structure of COM workflow with the states, transition, conditions. We implemented in COM content, and we're decoupling it for other extensions. So if you have your own extension and it's in Joomla 4, you can use it for your extension. Very easy, as you saw. You just have to change the extension parameter for creating the workflows, and then you have to change. We have an interface for it and workflow class in the library. So you just include this and say run transition, add transition, and stuff like that. So it's very less code. We have the plugin trigger implemented, so you can add an action-based approach. So if transition X is executed, do this, do that with plugins. And the last days we have some UX improvement, like you can change from all to some states or stuff like that. And what we are currently working at, that's the big last part we have to solve, is the migration process from Joomla 3 to Joomla 4. Because as I said before, there are different approach. We have to convert all the states values to the workflow values, so we have both. And we have to look how to do it. In the future, if this goes into Joomla, then we will add the workflow into other extension, user, contact, everything we have. We want to move the permissions into the workflow. Not all permissions, because creating permission doesn't make sense, but edit permission makes sense. And we want to interact with the version functionality. As you know, perhaps, if you create an article and have the versioning activated, there will be a new version and you can reword it. The problem at the moment is, let's say I create an article and I have a publisher. I create it, the publisher say, it works, publish it. If I have no edit permissions, I can edit this article when it's online and change it live on the website. And what we want to do is to create a versioning permission. So if I edit it, the new version will be created, but it's not automatically published. So a publisher can go in and publish it afterward, like a draft functionality. That will be somewhere in the future. Yeah.
I have a question.
Yes.
Is this already implemented in Alpha 3 or just
no.
released?
No.
So
it's a pull request. There's a pull request existing for it.
Okay.
And we have to solve this migration process, then it will be implemented.
Do you need testers or something?
Yes, I can do it. Next step, perhaps you remember the chalkboard, and perhaps you know the movie, and coming from 2020, I can say you the movie has some error in it. We have some timelines problem, so have your smartphones. So we need for your smartphone, because we have the past, we have the now, and we have two scenarios, two timelines. We can implement the workflow until 2020, or Drupal is ruling the web. So here is the pull request. So I ask you to bookmark this link, make a photo from the QR code, and test it and comment it. And we know there are a lot of UX issues, so please test it and give feedback to UX cases. So what do you don't like, what do you like, where can we improve? And if you have any questions, send me an email. I'm happy to answer it. Thanks.